Jules Bledsoe, a Waco, Texas native, was a pioneering artist during the early decades of the 20th century. Although widely known for being the original voice of Old Man River from the musical Showboat, his career and output was more expansive and historically significant. He was one of the first African-American singers to perform with opera companies in the United States and abroad. Bledsoe concertized frequently at notable venues such as New York's Carnegie Hall to much critical acclaim and graced stages in Europe, garnering much praise for his powerful voice and stirring renditions. Bledsoe was also a composer of ballads, art songs, and patriotic songs, as well as an arranger of folk songs and spirituals. His sterling reputation afforded the opportunity to perform an original composition, Ode to America, for Eleanor Roosevelt on an NBC radio broadcast in 1941. In spite of his accomplishments, scholarship on Bledsoe's remarkable career and artistic output is minimal. Whereas a few authors have addressed historical and social issues regarding his career as a performer, none have critically examined his compositional output. My work seeks to shed light on the compositions of Jules Bledsoe through analyses of select works found in the archival holdings of Baylor University's Texas collection. Based on a survey of recital and concert programs in the Texas collection, a number of Bledsoe's pieces apparently belonged to a performance tradition of Black singers who, at the turn of the century, sang original renditions of spirituals and folk songs at the ends of concerts. Taking into account the time in which Bledsoe was an active composer, one is compelled to examine his work within the frame of Eileen Southern's, quote, Black nationalistic, end quote, tenets, in which composers consciously turn to the folk music of their people as a source of inspiration. For example, Bledsoe's Go Down Moses is an arrangement of a Black folk spiritual that was realized for and performed on the concert stage. I have not yet examined the Bledsoe collection in New York's Schomburg Library, but the extensive holdings of the Texas collection reveal that Go Down Moses is one of the first original compositions that Bledsoe programmed. Of importance to local history, my research shows that this piece is the first original work that Bledsoe performed in Waco. Bledsoe returned to Waco in 1925 to give a recital at his home church, New Hope Baptist Church. Offering a program of pieces by European composers such as Handel, Brahms, and Elgar, Bledsoe concluded the concert with Go Down Moses. While it is not known whether Bledsoe introduced the piece as an original arrangement, I like to imagine him doing so and beaming with pride among his relatives and friends who are undoubtedly just as proud. I will forego the technical jargon associated with the analytical side of my work, which focuses on attributes of style and formal parameters such as harmony or rhythm. But such work in conjunction with historical considerations repositions Bledsoe as a versatile artist who upheld Black nationalistic tenets in performance and composition during the early decades of the 20th century.